Okay, Sir Rani. Kumusta po yung anong masasabi mo dito sa batch na batch 5?
Batch 5, yes.
5. Anong masasabi mo sa kanila?
Well, batch 5 is very extraordinary.
Okay.
Why? In the sense na yung waiting period ng pagdating ng batch 5, it took 5 months. It took 5 months. Can you see the significance? Batch 5, bago kami makapag-umpisa, I had to wait for 5 months, almost half a year.
Mm-hmm.
That is how special they are.
Mm-hmm.
Kaya nung dumating sila, sabi ko sa kanila, I've been waiting for you, all of you guys.
Mm-hmm.
I could not wait to receive you.
Mm-hmm.
That is one part. The most important thing sa pagiging special nila, kasi batch 1, batch 2, batch 3, batch 4, I set a standard. Bawat batch, I test their limit.
Okay.
Based doon sa given training regulation ng TESDA.
Mm-hmm.
Plus my own training background
mm-hmm.
in animal production.
Mm-hmm.
Bago ako nag-TESDA, bago ako naging ATI, I'm a practitioner
mm-hmm.
ng goat breeding, small ruminant. Again, part ng animal production sa small ruminant.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a practitioner. I've invested all my saving of my hard-earned money from Middle East, almost 40 years here in this farm.
Okay.
Kaya alam ko ang business. Yun ang in-inject ko din doon sa training regulation.
Mm-hmm.
So bawat bat, tinetest ko sila.
Okay.
And bawat bat, kapag napasa nila yung susunod na batch, had to level or
higher.
Ganun
yun. Pahirap.
Yes, pahirap ng pahirap. That is the quality of training that I started here.
Okay.
Hindi ka pwede to go below. No. It had to go up and up.
Mm. Okay. Sir, tatanong ko naman, kumusta naman ang D. Constantinos Farm so far?
Oh, my goodness. The Constantinos Farm, to tell you the truth, we are surviving.
Okay.
We are still, the effect of pandemic put us in a very, very brinks of collapse.
Mm-hmm.
Yung pandemic kasi, as I mentioned to you, put us in a situation where we could not do anything. Animals are, kasi pagdating sa program, I had that expertise. Eh.
Okay.
I'm proud to say that I had the expertise. I am blessed with the people who provided me with a scholarship.
Okay.
So again, the Constantinos Farm are here. What we are doing here is more on the advocacy side.
Okay.
Ang aking katwira, more for others, less for us.
Okay.
We believe that God will bless us in the afterlife. Na, my goodness, naiyak ako. Dahil, I have all the reason not to come back to the Philippines. The type of job that I'm enjoying in the Middle East is such. I've been blessed with a good job. Everything free, tax free. I don't have to worry about our life.
Mm-hmm.
But because of the advocacy to help others, not expecting that all this force majeure will happen in a single year. All my savings are gone in just because of the pandemic. But I always believe God has a better plan for us.
Available na po ang agribusiness merch sa Shopee. Ang link na sa description box.
Ito na naman tayo kasi may bago tayong tour ulit ngayong May.
Uh-huh.
Actually, hindi siya bago. Second time na natin itong gagawin kasi ginawa na natin ito last year. Ito,
parang rerun.
Rerun natin ito kasi mataas yung demand niya.
Mm-hmm.
Marami pong gustong maka-experience ulit. Ito po yung Thai fruit or shard tour. Yeah. So, gagawin po ito sa Chantaburi, Thailand.
Yes.
Ang tinatawag na fruit basket ng Thailand.
Uh-oh.
Sa May 7 to 10. Uh-oh.
Sobrang nag-enjoy ako doon sa mga eat all you can na prutas.
Marami pong reasons para bumalik sa Chantaburi. Unang-una na po yung fruit buffet. Na bawat farm po na pupuntahan natin ay nag-o-offer ng fruit buffet. So,
sawa tayo sa fruits
na kasama ang durian, mangustin, lansones, rambutan, longan, at salak, hindi pa sa ating
snake
popular
fruit. Magaganda yung mga places, no? Like yung durian land. Grabe yun. Super. Super. Ito na yung pinakamagandang lugar na napuntahan ko. No? Yung magnitude ng laki ng farm, how organized, yung irrigation, gumawa sila ng mga dam nila, may sarili silang restaurant on top of the mountain. Sobrang ganda talaga.
Yung large-scale durian farming, parang yun yung trend ngayon. Yung talagang malakihan
talaga.
Napakalaki po ng demand ng China for durian. So, kahit po sa Malaysia, kahit sa Vietnam, ito po ang trend talagang malakihan na plantation ng durian. So, makikita po din natin yun, makakapag-benchmark tayo. Mm-hmm. Yun po yung very important sa tour na to. Kasi may premium pagka-organic ka talaga.
Ibang presyo talaga.
Even though multiply siya 5 times or even higher pagka-organic siya. So, it's something to look into para dun sa mga farmers natin dito sa Philippines. Kasama na po dyan yung beekeeping.
Yeah.
Kasi para maging organic siya.
So, kumusta ma'am? Ano yung update doon sa export? Kaya ba ng Pilipinas pasukin ng export? Doon nag-start na tayo, but masyado pa rin maliit, no?
Kulang. Parang more than 80% pa yung kakulangan natin sa supply. Doon sa binibigay sa ating opportunity ng China.
Ano yung best varieties ngayon na kailangan itanim? Ano yung inihingi ng market?
Gagawin po natin ulit, sir, yung favorite mo na lahat ng variety. Titikman natin.
And then sabi niya, 20 varieties.
20 varieties. Hindi na muna natin sasabihin alin yung pinakamasarap. Para hulaan nila.
Hulaan na lang.
Alin yung pinakamahal. Pwede niyo po kaming i-message sa Facebook page namin, Inspired Learning Tours. Yun po ang pinakamabilis na paraan para makontakt po kami. Sana po mag-contactin niyo na po kami agad kasi konti na lang po
konti yung slots.
Paubos na rin po siya para makasama po kayo dito sa susunod nating tour. Sana po makasama kayo habang may available slots pa. Contactin niyo na po kami.
Because I believe in the words of Jeremiah 29:11, that the plan of God is for me to have a better future, that no harm will come upon me. I have to be patient, and this is what I'm doing. With on the brighter side, I would like to thanks DAATI for giving me the opportunity to become part of their learning site, in providing again a pre-course teaching to many farmers here in this community, plus the most blessed things that happened to the farm. When Kong John Bertis, who's now Deputy Director General of TESDA, allowed me to become one of TESDA's registered, authorized farm school in implementing scholarship program for animal production ruminant NC2. That allowed me to breed at least that the scholar who do the farm development here, I don't have to worry about the manpower. At the same time, I'm able to help them. It's a mutual beneficial to both of us. So, the Constantino is here to engage in the nation building in food security, for providing the job employment abroad, that all those people will, as they save, they become a regular taxpayer that contribute the economy of the Philippines. Mm-hmm. It's a long process, but again, my orientation is like this. More for others, less for ourselves, knowing that God will always bless us, even not in this lifetime, but in the afterlife.
Mm-hmm. Sir, wala ka bang regrets?
Well, as a human, there are times na dumadating yung time na I ask myself. Mm-hmm. Alam mo, yung aking, hindi naman sa pagyayabang, I reach the peak of my career. Yeah. I don't have to dig. I don't have to break my palm. Ay, kito nyo. Ang hinahawakan lang nito ay ball pen. Mm-hmm. I have people, if I want tea, I have just to call. In just one ring, people will serve me. But the Lord, the plan of God is not like that. Pero nung dumating yung dilubyo, alam mo, 2019, sabi ko, I will retire. Despite of the luxurious lifestyle ko sa Middle East, na again, I give credit to the higher one. Mm. Kasi hindi ko naman magagawa yun kung wala siya. Mm. Pero, dumating ang time na I had to choose. Na babalik ba ako sa Pilipinas para to help or not. Kaya nung ako ay nag-tender ng aking early retirement, when I tender my early retirement to the company, my immediate boss, who happened to be a Canadian prince, I can easily recall yung sinabi niya, you must be mad. Why you are tendering your early retirement? You're still too young to retire. And the company wanted you. What else you want to you for you to stay? I said, you don't have. Please, do not offer me something that I cannot say no. I am going back to the Philippines to become part of the nation building of our country. If I fail to return to the Philippines, I'll miss the big ride. I'm already 50 years old, and I cannot wait another 50 years to return to the Philippines. And I return to the Philippines with the hope that I will be part of the big team. And that's what happened. In 2019, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. 8 months, akong nag-produced one of the finest goat in history in the Philippines. Mm. I said history in the Philippines kasi I produce F3. Nobody believe that I could produce F3. I have all the documentation. Mm. It's well recorded. Pictures, record, videos. Mm-mm. It's an evidence that I can produce. After 8 months, here comes the national calamity. Mm-mm. Again, January, ano nangyari? Nagkaroon ng super typhoon. When there are typhoon, all the crop will be affected. All the forage will be submerged. Limited ang pagkain. But I manage to import silage. Yung mga buro, pag sinabing mga naka-container yan. So I manage and my livestock survive. After that, comes February. Pumutok ang Taal. Taal, volcanic ash spread until here.
Okay.
Ibig sabihin, lahat ng grass is covered with ash. And that is affecting our livestock. Again, we import different silage, hay, lahat yan. We survive. Come March 15, what happened? Pandemic. And that is the start of the misery of the farm. But we survived. We convert, we lost everything, but we convert. We practice the 3R principle again. If you notice, I keep on telling 3R principle, 5S principle, lahat ng naandito must be utilized to become more productive. And that's what we are doing now. So, I think we are okay. Mm. As long as they are, we continue what we are doing now, providing scholarship in partnership of TESDA and ATI. Mm-hmm.
Sir, ano ang meron ang D. Constantinos Farm na wala sa lahat ng training school and farm school and what's the other one?
Learning site.
Learning site.
Okay. So, ang kakaibahan ko kasi, okay, again, I want to make it the point na yung to become a learning site, it's a big achievement already.
Okay.
Okay? So, hindi mo pwedeng sabihin na I'm best, you're not best. But ang kakaibahan ko, ang pinanggalingan, ang orientation ko kasi, nagsimula ako sa napakahirap. Diba? Again and again, sinabi ko sa inyo, ako'y nanggaling sa being an OFW na hindi naman ako ordinaryong OFW. Mm. I reached the peak of my career. Mm. Lahat libre. Mm. I returned to the Philippines just to become a farmer. Mm-mm. Kasi yung ibang school, farmer na yung mga yan. Mm-mm. They apply as a farmer. Yun talaga yung kanilang core of business eh.
Yes, yes.
Yung farming. Ako hindi eh. Okay. Ang core of business ko ay nasa modern technology mining.
Okay.
Wala akong background sa agriculture. Mm. Ang background ko ay yung to build a high-rise building, yung kagaya ng tallest building sa Dubai. Mm-hmm. Kami ang nag-design yan, nag-supply ng mga equipment.
Okay.
Sa Saudi, Aramco, lahat yan. Lahat ng mahihirap about mining, alam ko yan. Pagdating sa agriculture, wala ako. So, nag-aral talaga ako.
Okay.
I emerged in a place where I don't have any background. Mm-hmm. The risk na ay ginawa ko, yung risk factor na napakalaki na umuwi ako sa Pilipinas, mm-hmm. yun ang aking risk. Na na-disgrasya pa rin ako dahil sa pandemic. Mm-hmm. Yun ang kakaibang ko. Talagang ako ay nagpakahirap. Pero hindi, I never give up. Mm-hmm. Kaya alam ko ang sakit ng, ang hirap na pinagdadaanan ng isang farm. Mm-hmm. Anong kakaibahan ko? Again, bago ako pumasok sa TESDA, talagang yung course na yon during pandemic, talagang naitawid ko yon. Mm-hmm. Kaya pinahalagahan ko ngayon yung aking binibigay na scholarship. Okay. Na hindi lang ako nagbibigay ng scholarship, I want to make sure that the scholar who benefit with the money of all our taxpayer, mm-hmm. I really benefit to the maximum. Mm-hmm. Na sila ay makapunta sa abroad, ayaw man nilang makapunta sa abroad, they start up their own business in a very systematic way. Okay. Yun ang kakaibahan ko sa kanila. Alam ko yung hirap, at ang isa pa, meron akong puso. Talaga na, sabi ko nga, more for others, less for myself. Again, mahirap intindihin, pero yun ang aking orientation. Eh. Mm-hmm. I just need only a few things para to survive. I don't want a luxurious, hindi ko kasi ginagawa itong test as a source of business.
Okay.
That is my different to others. Okay. Hindi ito ang source ng business ko. It is a source to help others. Let me end that way. Ang pagiging learning site ko, ang pagiging TESDA farm school ko, I decide not to make it as a source of business income, but it become a source where people fulfill, reach their dreams, to change their, to reach their dream. Mm-hmm. Yun ang kakaibang ko.
Okay, sir. Follow-up question pa ako, sir. You mentioned na umuwi ka, di ba, despite of yung magandang trabaho and all. And marami rin, no? Madaming OFW, not only OFWs, pati yung mga nag-migrate.
Migrants workers.
Oh, yan. They're also planning, no, to venture into farming.
Okay.
Sir, paano mag-manage ng risk and expectations?
Yeah. Okay, inom lang ako ng konti.
Yes, sir.
Pinaiyak mo ako, Sir Buddy.
Bawi ako sa iyo kanina, sir.
Pinaiyak mo ako eh. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Anong, please,
manage expectations and the risk.
Okay, very good question. I think learning from my experience, ang may advice ko sa mga nagbabalak na mga OFW o migrant workers, first thing first, while you are still there, save. Pahalagahan nyo ang inyong kinikita. A very simple rules in life, you must identify what is the needs and what is the necessity. That is the most important thing. What is the need and what is the necessity? Okay. Once you already identify what is need and necessity, you'll be able to save. When you save, please plan what really what you want. If in case you want to go into agri, let's say if you want to go engage in a farm in the field of livestock, okay, let's put my farm. Example, you want to engage in ruminants, baka, tupa, lahat yan. Consider your, unang-una sa mga hayop, kailangan malaki yung lupa mo.
Okay.
Why? Ang unang pupublimahin mo dyan ay yung you need to have your source of forage supply.
Okay.
Ito naman nangyari ng pandemic. Based on my experience, nangamatay, tumaas ang mortality ng aking mga alaga dahil lahat ng mga supply dito na pagkain ay hindi nakarating dahil nga nag-lockdown. Kung ang farm ay merong mas malaki dahil nga ang balak namin dito hindi lamang limited ang size. Ang ideal kasi sa small ruminant, ito, sa small ruminant ideal is 3 hectares.
Wow, for three how many heads?
Okay. Ganto ang ratio. Na yan yung mga tinuturo ko. 3 hectares. Start with 30 doe. Pag sinabing to, inahin.
Okay.
At meron kang dalawang barako.
Okay. Okay?
Yung dalawang barako, with 30 breeded doe, makakapag-breed ka na dyan.
Okay.
O, 30 lang sa 3 hectares. Mm. Sa 3 hectares kasi, bawat isang kambing will eat 3 kilo every day.
Okay.
Ngayon, kailangan 1 hectare is for your structures. 1 hectare is for your grazing area.
Okay.
1 hectare is for your planting area. So you are secured. You'll be able to sustain your farm. 3 hectares. So, ibig sabihin niyan, you must save. Once you have that one, then ano susunod? Right people, right skills and knowledge.
Mm-mm.
Sa mga mag-i-engage, kailangan, you, like what I did, you don't stop learning. You do your own self-learning research.
Mm.
Kahit na dyan ka sa ibang bansa, ngayon, the technology is very advanced.
Accessible.
You could research online.
Mm.
That's what I did.
Mm.
Ngayon, ang isa ko pang i-advise sa inyo, i-avail nyo ang lahat ng mga pre-program ng ating gobyerno. The government are providing pre-seminars.
Mm.
You approach your nearest regional office ng DA through ATI, Agricultural Training Institute. All these things are available nationwide. Avail that one. Gain all those knowledge. Equip yourself with knowledge and skills. Yun ang una. First, you must have that financial strength. Then, knowledge and knowledge. Skills na makukuha mo. You have to start with your own initiative, research. And then, avail the government pre-training. And then, pagkatapos nun, select the best man to protect your guy. And again, you cannot do business, running a business without risk is no business at all. Running a business without risk is no business at all. In business, there is always attached with risk. There is no business without risk. Okay. Always remember that. Mm-mm. Yung risk kasi, malelesen mo lang yung percentage niyan.
Okay.
So, yun lang sa akin, you don't get overwhelmed dahil merong napanood kayo na ganito, gusto niyo agad doon. You have this self-assessment. Can I do that one? Mm. Ready ba akong gawin yun? Mm. Kasi farming is not it's not easy job. Mm. It's required 24 hours dedication. Mm. 24 hours dedication. You cannot do this remote control. Mm. This can be, remote control can be done in a foreign land. Kaya nga sila ay nag-hire ng mga expert eh, consultant. Magmo-monitor lang sila. Mm. Pero you as a new starter sa business, you must be involved. Hands-on ka dapat. It's required dedication and heart and of course faith in the higher one. Mm-hmm. Without that one, then the failure percentage is very high. Mm-hmm. But if you equip with all these things, the success is very high. But again and again, I want to end, there is no shortcut to success.
Okay.
There's no shortcut to success. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Sir, can you work around with the risk to be your advantage?
Yes. Good question again. Let me give you the actual scenario here in the farm.
Okay.
Di ba sabi ko sa iyo, lahat ng aking retirement fund, even my retirement fund, I inject it here in the farm.
In your personal.
Oo. Di ba? Siguro, wala lang ibang good example kundi yun nangyari sa aming totoo.
Okay.
I invested some money here. I even invested, that is the lesson learned. Mm-hmm. I even invested my retirement fund here. Ngayon, dumating ang pandemic. Tinanaroon ko yung pandemic situation to revive yung energy ng farm. Mm-hmm. Para makatulong ng marami. Mm-hmm. Kasi kung walang pandemic, hindi marirealize ng karamihan ng tao na ang farming is the source of everything. Mm-hmm. In our country. Mm-hmm. Why? Our country depend on import. Mm-hmm. We used to be a number one exporter ng rice. But mm-hmm. where are we now? We even import galunggong. Di ba?
Yeah.
We even import galunggong. Anyway, what I'm saying is, tinanaroon ko yung risk to help more.
Okay.
To help more. Na ang aking katwiran dito, tinan mo ha, yung mga idol building ko dito, ngayon, na-transport,
it's
become a facility. Siguro naman, kahit sinong pumunta dito, this will pass the requirement.
Yeah.
Na ito ay hindi, yung 3R ay naandito lahat. Mm-hmm. Na lahat ay natuto. Mm-hmm. It's a very evident na ang ginagawa dito, mm-hmm. despite ng risk na nangyari, ay nakakatulong pa rin. Mm-hmm. At we continue to survive. Mm-hmm. That is the beauty of it, na yung risk na turn around, na napakalaki, kung hindi siguro nag-pandemic, I'll be relaxed. Mm-hmm. I'll be relaxed. Nasasabihin ko, that's it, let's close down. Let's declare bankruptcy. And go back to, and enjoy our remaining retirement day. Pero nag-pandemic, and then we realized na, food security, kung walang farm, walang tao na matututo ng skill, ay wala nang magtutuloy ng farming. Mm-hmm. Diba? Isa pa, it's just hit in my sense. Alam mo ba ang ratio ng mga farmers natin? Mm. Wala nang farmers na gustong magtuloy after 70 years. Mm. Karamihan sa mga farmers natin na are getting old, sino susunod sa kanila? Ang mga anak nila, nakita nila yung hirap ng tatay nila, ayaw na nila mag-farming. Mm-mm. Let me just redefine what is being a farmer. Hindi naman dahil farmer ka, engage ka lang sa pagtatanim ng palay.
Yes.
Hindi lang yan. Hindi dahil farmer ka, ikaw ay nagtatanim ng kung ano-ano. Mm-hmm. Ng kamati, sili, lahat yan. Kita mo nangyayari sa Baguio. Mm-hmm. Tinatapo yung tunelet ng kamatis. Mm-hmm. Di ba? Ang ginagawa kasi natin dito sa TESDA, sa animal production, is a modern farming. We change the landscape ng impression sa isang farmer.
Okay.
Kaya nga yung aking mga estudyante, sila yung mga professional in their own field. Yes. And they decided to come here and learn the animal production. Why? The opportunity become bigger. Okay. Kasi intention nila, pagdating ng panahon, pag tinanong ang mga anak nila, di ba, sa mga school, may assignment doon. Tell me about your father. Tell me about your mother. Oh, nakalagay, my mother is a dentist. My father is an engineer. And here comes Pedro. Anak ni Pedro, ayaw tumayo, nahihiya dahil ang father niya ay farmer. I want to change that one. Ang tatay ko ay farmer and we have the school. Ako nga eh, di ba? I'm a farm scientist. I'm proud to say I'm a farm scientist in the field of ruminant, small. I'm a farm scientist. Kaya nga magsasaka scientist ah. So iba, na, ang category ng gusto kong ibigay na impression, do not. Kay gusto kong ibalik yung glory na hindi nakikita ng iba na ang mga magsasaka ay real, true hero. Hindi lamang sa papel. Kasi yung hirap na ginagawa nila to ensure na we have the food security ay nakikita ko. Ngayon, yung mga anak, kaya nga sabi ko sa mga farmers association dito, I'm here in Cavite. I am the true blood of Caviteño. Please, let me help you. I'm gonna provide you the scholarship for your son and daughter, the next blood generation niya.
Okay.
Para sila ay makapag-abroad. Para ma-encourage sila. Na yung farming ngayon, iba na. Hindi na sila kailangan magtanim ng palay. Iba lang farming to. Animal production. So, yun ang gusto kong ibigay na encouragement sa ating mga kabataan. Ang ino-offer ng TESDA through the Constantinos Farm Animal Production ay pinadali, lalo ng ating gobyerno, hindi na kailangan ng college diploma. Lalong pinadali. As long as you have the heart, the willingness, you could be an scholar of TESDA. Kung ikaw man hindi nakapag-aral dahil sa hirap ng buhay, kaya nahihiya ka, nawawalan ka ng pag-asa, dahil wala kang tinapos, dito sa TESDA. Dito ka pumunta. Dahil dito, pwede ka lang makipagsabayan sa mga MBA, BS course. Dahil ang NC2 ay well-recognized worldwide.
Sir, anong message mo naman sa mga gustong maging estudyante ng TESDA para sa farm school?
Okay, my message to all possible interested applicant to become a scholar of TESDA, regardless where region it is, ay you better examine yourself kasi ang pagiging scholar ng TESDA required, what is required? Ang required is dedication. Dedication. Kasi why? When you become a scholar of TESDA, always remember na ang nagpapaaral sa inyo ay ang Republic of the Philippines. Required a true dedication from you. No less than 100%. Why? If you are not serious about it, please do not misuse the opportunity na pwede makuha ng iba. Pero if you have that, kailangan lang dyan dedication. Dedication to become a scholar. Farming is not a joke. It's not a joke. It's required 8 hours a day from Monday to Saturday. Sunday lang ang off nyo for family day. Kailangan kung ikaw ang full concentration ay nasa farming. Hindi po pwede na, you cannot do two things at the same time. You cannot work while you are studying in the animal production or wherever. Kasi I'm speaking for animal production. Mm-hmm. I cannot speak for other qualification. Okay. Animal production required 8 hours training days. It's a full time. Mm-hmm. Hindi po pwede ang half-hearted. Kaya ang kailangan dito ay talagang meron kang commitment. Mm-hmm. Na dito kasi, if you have the commitment, you already pass. If you are half-hearted, may chance ka pa rin naman to realize kung ano ba ang gusto mong gawin. Mm-hmm. Ang aking lang requirement ay napakasimple. 18 years old above. Although I'm allowed to take 15 years old in a, under TTSP, mm-hmm. Tulong Trabaho Scholarship Program, 15 years old. Pero we prepared as advised by our advisor na it should be 18 years old, mm-hmm. above. Mm-hmm. Filipino citizen. It must be 18 years old above, Filipino citizen. Hindi ko kailangan at least high school graduate. Kung hindi man siya high school graduate, kahit siya ay tapos ng alternative learning school. Mm-hmm. O ano pang gusto nyo? Kapag meron na kayo noon, please send it to our email address. Or you could contact ang agribusiness, si Sir Buddy. Mm-hmm. Makipag-coordinate lang kay Sir Buddy at Sir Buddy with the Sir Buddy become our partners in spreading this scholarship program, mm-hmm. Sir Buddy. Mm-hmm. Na hindi nyo kailangan pumunta dito para mag-apply. Yun lang 3 initial requirement. Pag naipasin nyo na yon, then you will be shortlisted. And then we will do the next step, which is the personal interview. Mm-hmm. When you pass, then you become an scholar. As simple as that. Mm-hmm.
Sir, baka hindi ko kayang sagutin lahat ng mga inquiries. What's your phone number? Pwede ko okay. Nang tawagan.
Okay. The Constantinos Farm. Farm email is The Constantinos Farm, tuloy-tuloy yun, D Constantinos.
Letter D.
Letter D. Mm. D, then The Constantinos Farm. At gmail.com.
Okay.
Sa Facebook ay marami akong admin doon. Mm-hmm. You just search The Constantinos Farm Corporation.
Okay.
Makikita na yun doon, and then you just message, and then 24 hours na may nagmo-monitor doon.
Okay.
Whatever inquiry you need, we will revert back to you and then give you a proper reply.
Mm-hmm. Sir Ronnie, thank you so much. Worth the wait.
My phone number. Yes. My phone number is 0917. Okay, ito na lang. Oh, tama. 0917-105-1366.
Ayan.
Again, 0917-105-1366.
Sir Ronnie, worth the wait talaga kami na kayo ay ma-feature namin dito sa agribusiness.
It is such an honor. Okay. Such an honor. To have you in the farm, I know you're so busy and your advocacy to spread the good news about agriculture business is such. And having us with your platform, mm-mm. in the social media platform is a extraordinary privilege. And with that, I salute you, Sir Buddy.
Thank you.
And the agribusiness team. Thank you.
Thank you po.
Thank you po.
Mm-mm. At mag-thank you rin tayo kay Congressman John Virgil.
Oh, yes! Tito, again, Tito John, Congressman, Deputy
Director General
of TESDA, John Anicieto, John Bertis III, in behalf of the Constantinos Farm Corporation, mm-hmm. We would like to express our deepest gratitude. Maraming salamat, Tito. At pinadala mo, you have mentioned our farm, your farm, para at least magkaroon ng magandang platform to spread yung advocacy program ng TESDA. At again, maraming salamat. Without you, I don't know if I am able at this status ng ating farm. Mm-hmm. Kasi si Tito ang nag-encourage sa akin na ituloy ang school na to despite of the situation that we have experienced. Tito, maraming salamat. Mm-hmm. Please get well soon. I know you've been working so hard. Take an extra rest. Alam mo, health is wealth. I want to see you where both of us are in good health condition. Mm-hmm. So that we could still share to many people here in the Philippines and abroad yung advocacy mo na sabi nga, TESDA sa TESDA, lingap, maasan, TESDA, abot lahat. Maraming salamat, Tito, and please extend my thanks to Secretary Teng Magudadatu, Regional Director, ang ating Provincial Rosalinda Talavera. Marami pong salamat sa lahat ng TESDA dito sa Region 4A. Marami pong salamat. Tito, Director General, Deputy Director General John Bertis, thank you very much and I salute you.
Okay, sir. Tawagan nyo lang talaga yan, Tito, sir.
Yes. Tawagan namin yan. Kasi talagang, in the real sense, we call our Tito kasi sa Saudi kasi, pag tinawag mo brother and sister, they immediately put you a red mark, tag, red tag ka agad, na you are practicing Christianity.
Oh, okay? I see.
So, we made it a point na Tagalog, Tito, Titas. So, it's become our honoring, Tito, Titas. So, it's become more on respect. Mm-hmm. But, in the true sense, talagang Tito and Tita, Tito at Tito ko rin siya. Kasi talagang more than blood yung pinagsamahan namin sa pagtulong. Nandito na sila sa mga individual kidding pen. So, sasabihin ko lang sa kanila na mag... Para makita mo yung difference ng mga type ng goat.
Oo.
Kasi may F1, F2, F3.
Mm-mm. Available na po ang Agribusiness merch sa Shopee. Ang link nasa description box. Agribusiness, how it works. Instruct, inspire, succeed.